Mankind has been around for thousands of years. They've done some really good things for the planet. They've done some really good things for themselves. But there will always be the bad things. The mistakes that mankind remembers and will never forget. Most horrors created by man themselves. And others caused by man themselves. Like the gas bombings of New York of 2023. Or the failed military robotics AI test of 2026. Besides from taking things from themselves, humans have also managed to take away things from our beloved planet. What used to be beautiful and green is now nothing but a rocky wasteland, uninhabitable, no living creatures as far as the eye can see, except for the human. Together, I believe we can change this. A chance to start anew and erase the mistakes of Earth. A new home, a better home for humans to thrive and change. Hi. I'm Damien Ramey, and if you would like to join me on this life-changing trip, there's a certain space vessel I would like to tell you about.
Alfred! Alfred, I'm home! Hey there, Alfred. Just got home. Sad that this is probably going to be our very last trip around Earth, huh? That new fancy space shuttle octopus! Yay! I'll tell you what. The whole damn thing is a publicity stunt. They don't actually care about saving mankind. They just want to sell their stuff, you know? What's that, Malfred? It also provides a legitimate way to get off this wasteful planet. I guess you're right there. Come on, let's get the things out of the car. The launch is at 3. Plus, I keep getting these ads all over the place. Space Shuttle Octopus. Travel is the future. Travel is the key. I don't know what they're saying, but I'm tired of it. It's saying that the Captain Damien Ramey is going to personally greet all of the guests. I doubt that, Malfred. What's that, Malfred? I should stop being so hard on him. Well, what do you know? Look at me. I'm the one reasoning with myself. You're just a cow. You probably don't even understand me. Yeah, personally greet all the guests. You know what I'm gonna do? Hi, I'm Damien Ramey, captain of the ship. Welcome aboard. Oh yeah, hi, I'm Alec Reynolds. Punch in the face. I hate those snarky millionaires. I know. Really, the thing is, I'm just... upset. I'm upset with mankind. They had their chance. We had our chance, and we blew it, we polluted it, we messed it all up, we blew a bunch of things up. I'm sorry, Malfred. I knew you've always been there for me, but like, I mean, you're no offense, but you're a cow. I'm sorry, I'm so alone. You're pretty much all I've had for the past 3 years. Very little human interaction, that's what I want most. Yeah, I know it might get better once we reach a new planet. I just hope we don't screw it up like we did Earth, you know? And I tell you what, the next time I hear, I'm Damien Ramy. Welcome to Space Shuttle Octopus. I'm just gonna... I'm gonna freak. Yeah, I know, I'm coming. Malfred, everything's going to be okay, right? Right? I'm probably just over-exaggerating. Come on, we don't want to be late for the ship leaving. We don't want to be left behind. That would be a nightmare. No. Where are you going? You're going in the back. I'm opening the door. You secure back there, Malfred? All right, let's go.
Come fly with me. Let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay. Come fly with me. Let's fly away. Come fly with me, let's float down.
I'm your captain, Damien Ramy. Welcome to Space Shuttle Octopus, where travel is the future. Yeah, no, I don't know. I think that tagline may be like a little like too much. The tagline could be whatever you want it to be, sir. Yeah, I know. It's just that like I don't know how to do taglines. I'm just gonna be honest. I know I'm the captain, but I don't know how to do taglines.
What does being the captain have to do with knowing taglines?
I don't know. I mean, you would imagine I'd be kind of hip or something, right? I mean, I named the damn thing Space Shuttle Octopus, you know, for marketing reasons, and like, I don't know. Just, it completes me. I need to come up with a new tagline, alright? And I better have that by the end of the day.
Alright, sir. Quick question.
Actually, Jason, I don't have any more time for questions. The takeoff's at 3. Oh, by the way, I just wanted to thank you so much for being my co-captain. This is a historic moment for mankind. Travel is the future. You know what? I think I am going to keep that as the tagline. It does sound pretty kick, if you get what I'm saying. That's what young people are saying nowadays, right? That it's kick. I need to learn that too. Again, for marketing reasons. All right, let's head out.
Sir, don't you need your face protection for the toxic environment outside?
I mean, everybody's evacuated and gone to the ship's waiting area. I mean, who doesn't know about Space Shuttle Octopus at this point? Plus, if the air is still relatively dirty, then the cleaning crews are definitely not doing their job, and we can complain it to the city. You're right, it won't matter. This city's getting abandoned anyways.
Ah, what a beautiful day out it is today. Is that my car?
Well, yes, it appears to have been flipped.
Oh, yeah, I see that. Dang, this whole city's gone pretty bad, huh?
Yes.
Just think about it, Jason. Soon, me, Damien Ramy, hero of humanity, forever remembered in history.
How nice,
Now come on, we're gonna miss the launch.
Oh, wow, geez, that much for just a sack of food? Well, I guess they are going to be way more expensive on that ship.
Well, talking about the ship, you told me and my compadres that you were gonna get us some tickets, along with a great, great amount of money that you owe us. Any idea when that'll come around?
Oh no, yeah, I'll give it to you soon, no worries. Just gotta get to the ship right now, definitely.
Alright, well just remember that if you don't pay up, me and my gang will come up guns at the ready, alright?
Alright, got that. You're the best, big boss man.
Don't call me that.
Alright, I won't call you that. Definitely ever again. We did it, Malford. We made it to the ship. Oh, yeah, you're right. We gotta load out the stuff, huh? Yeah, I've seen what the ship looks like, Malford. It can't impress me. It can't be that big, Malford. Well, I did look behind me, and there's nothing there, alright?
Turn around and then look up? Why do you want me to turn around and then look up? What am I supposed to Oh my god.
Alright, Malford. I may have underestimated the sweetness of this ship, and I apologize. What the? Oh my god, piloting is so much fun! Wait a second, if it's a spaceship, is it piloting or am I a captain? Oh hey, glad to know I'm not the only one that missed his alarm. What's with the helicopter? Oh, nothing really, just wanted to come in style, you know how it is. Right. What's your name? Oh, my name is... Aw, oh, man, that's the ship's clock alarm. We need to be inside already. Come on, I'll guide you in. No, we're not going to try the helicopter. Oh man, you're gonna love it here. There's like 5-10 different pools. There's a bunch of built-in McDonald's, and there's a Buffalo Wild Wings, I think. It's in there somewhere. We have a bunch of movie theaters. There's so many snack bars and actual bars, and there's the kind of clubs. There's the other kinds of clubs, if you know what I mean. There's just so much. Now, wait over here in this area, will ya? Kind of crazy, don't you think, Malford? Oh, well, let's go.
Yeah, Malford, I think we're just waiting for some big speech or something. I'm not too sure.
When are we just going to get to go to our rooms already?
I know, right? We don't want to hear some dumb speech.
Ladies and gentlemen of Space Shuttle Octopus, boys and girls, please welcome your captain.
Hey! Oh, hello everybody! Yes, it's me, the captain of Space Shuttle Octopus. Or, better known to some people, especially kids, as that one guy on the TV who keeps saying, I'm Damien Ramy. Welcome to Space Shuttle Octopus. Yeah, yeah, that ad got annoying after a while. But, hey, don't worry, because now we're on the ship, and we're going to save the planet by leaving it. Who's ready? Yeah, I know. It's exciting, isn't it? Not only did we ruin Earth, but we're going to find some other planet to ruin. How about that? Just kidding. We're all just kidding here. We don't mean that, really. We're just moving to another planet that's safer and more hospitable for our kind to survive and thrive for the next generations. Now, I know this is a very exciting moment for everybody involved, not only because my company is helping save the human race, but also because now we will have the opportunity to see our children, our grandchildren, and now with our new aging technology, our great-grandchildren, our great-great-grandchildren. We will see them strive and survive on a new world and protect it in a way that we couldn't protect Earth. They will protect that planet the way that we literally could never protect the Earth. They will make up for the mistakes of the past because we are the human race and we will get through anything together. Now, without further ado, I'm Damien Ramy and welcome to Space Shuttle Octopus. Now, if you excuse me, I have a ship to fly. But first, fly with me, let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay. Come fly with me, let's fly away.
Thanks for bringing the stuff up, Malfred. You really didn't need to do that. Ma'am? You having some trouble with your lock there?
Oh, no, not at all.
Okay. Our lock better not be as difficult to open. Let's look inside our room, Malfred. Well, you're right, Malfred. It's no five-star room particularly, but it is relatively clean. And you know all the rich celebrities are getting all the clean, fancy rooms with pools and actual kitchens. Oh, well, at least they actually got that bed that I ordered for you. I mean, it's a dog bed, but you can try and fit in there, Malfred. Well, better get comfortable, Malfred. This is how we're going to be living life for God knows how long until we find a new planet. Years. Who knows, maybe I'll already be dead by the time we find a new planet, which I wouldn't be surprised. The nearest hospitable planet is like, what, a few light years away? Unless we go at some supersonic speed, which I doubt has been invented. Has it? How am I supposed to know? I'm a dumb regular person. Huh. Well, I do feel like I'm forgetting something. Oh my gosh, we forgot the car! We're allowed to load cars onto this thing, Malfred! That has most of our stuff in it! Why didn't you remind me? Oh my god, we have to go get it! Well, actually, no, you just stay here. I'll go get it. Today's the day. You bet. And everything will go fine, right? Of course. Sir, where is your captain's outfit? I'm wearing mine. Where is yours? Well, I just wanted to be in more comfortable clothes. Plus, I'm going to be walking around the hallways, and I don't want people to be like, "Ooh, he's the captain." You know, just can I wear my normal clothes, please? Of course you can, sir. Yeah. Today is a historic day. Sir, I would literally be a rich man for how many times you've said that this is a historic day. Well, it depends. How much am I giving you? Is it like a nickel every time I say it? Or a dollar? Or a... Never mind, sir. Well, if you need me, I'm going to be walking around the hallways. You just don't touch anything. I'm going to see if they have one of those McDonald's. I hear they have McDonald's here. Can you believe that? We actually got a deal with them. A whole bunch of other fast food places. My god, this day is gonna be great, I'm telling you. Of course, sir. Of course. Oh, hey miss, do you need any help over there?
Oh, you must be Damien Rami, the captain of this ship.
Well, as a matter of fact, I am. You know, I'm gonna save humanity, and hopefully nothing will go wrong. I mean, I'm still working on the tagline. I'm not that good with taglines.
Just so you know, mister, I'm working with the government on this case, and I'm going to shut down your entire operation if I spot anything fishy.
But, I mean, does that even matter for the government? I mean, all of the world's governments...
Yeah, I know the other world governments are here. Just don't mess up, Damien the Never-Was-King. That's right, I've looked you up. I know about your attempt to run for King of North America and failure to do so.
Well, I mean, at least I actually attempted to run. I mean, what have you done?
As a matter of fact, I ran for president of the United Kingdom once. I didn't win, but at least I didn't drop out.
Wait, are you Jane Ritchie?
As a matter of fact, yes, I am.
I mean, I guess I expected other people of high regard to be on this ship.
Now, if you excuse me, I have to get back to serious work before the ship launches.
Okay,
A nice meeting you too, I guess. Jane Ritchie. Well, might as well keep walking around. Forget that I was insulted with my old nickname. Yeah, that happens sometimes, yeah. I gotta get the car, What are you doing out here? Aren't you the captain? Oh yeah, and where are you going? The ship's about to launch in like an hour. Unless you're going to one of the McDonald's we have here. We have more McDonald's than we know how to deal with. So what are you doing out here? Going to the McDonald's, right? No, it's just that I forgot that you could load cars onto this thing, and I told my cow to remind me, but it didn't, so now the car's still out there, and we're going to launch off into space. Please, I just need to go get it. Oh, you forgot your car, huh? And you're saying the cow didn't remind you? Okay, that sounds pretty crazy, but yeah, I gotta go get my car. Oh, well, shoot, man, don't worry, I'll personally escort you to go get your car. And I'm the captain, so if anyone defies me, I can fire them. Right. So you're saying you're gonna help me get my car, correct? Oh, no, yeah, don't worry. We'll be really quick, I promise you. We'll be in and out in a jiffy. Oh, well, okay. You are the captain.
There was really no one else who could remind you about the car? Just the cow?
Yeah.
Oh, well, come on, we should be able to get this thing onto the ship easy peasy lemon squeezy.
Really? I mean, it's a giant ship in the sky. Yeah, don't worry, just get inside, I'll drive you through it. Well, I guess technically you'll be driving, but yeah, just pay attention to what I say.
Okay.
Sir, an unexpected surprise. The captain has left the ship and is outside.
Perfect. Proceed with your operation.
Yes, sir.
Alright, now that your car is parked in that position, all I need to do is call up a ramp. Now the ramp is going to come down slowly.
Whoa.
Is that the ramp? No, that's the engine. What?
Oh my god, the ship! Oh my god, it's leaving without us! Hey! Hey, no! Hey, ship! Hey! Hey!
Too true.
Wait a second, why is the ship leaving without us? I don't know! I'm the captain! I don't know why it's leaving without me! Can they not see me through the windows? Hey, no, please stop! Please.
It left us.
The ship. It left us. The ship left us. We're all alone on this planet.
Not completely. You have me.
Oh, but who cares? You're probably the one that caused this.
I mean, you know, I got people too up there that I care about. I'm just worried about Malfred. I hope he's okay.
Well, hey, Malfred. Oh, so the cow gets to come with you. Not my assistant, not my personal assistant, not my side assistant, and not my assistant's assistant.
Those are the people you care about on the ship?
Well, no, not necessarily, but... I'm the captain! The ship can't leave without me!
You're right, that is a bit fishy.
Fishy? It's suspicious!
That's what fishy means.
No, something isn't right. I need to call up my special task force agents. Right, I left my phone on the ship, and they're on the ship. How am I supposed to call them? How am I supposed to update my Instagram?
You are a sad, strange little man. You have my pity.
But where are you going?
What? I'm going back to the survival camps. That's where food and water is. Mine's not too far from here, actually. You're welcome to come, if you want.
What? You want me to go into one of your poor people camps?
Or you can stay here and die.
Alright. I guess I have to come too.
Perfect! Alright, get in and give me a little bit to just load in Malfred.
Okay.
I didn't know the ship was supposed to take off yet. Excuse me, sir, why have we taken off early?
Captain's orders, ma'am. Now I'm gonna have to ask you to get back into your assigned space before trouble arrives.
Something's not right here. I know for a fact the ship wasn't supposed to take off early. Something's definitely not right here. I'm definitely gonna get to the bottom of this.
Sir, we have someone that's suspicious. What should we do?
Just do a normal checkup. We'll deal with her later.
Copy that. Hey, ma'am, stop right there. I'm gonna need to ask you for your ticket and your ID.
Ticket and ID? Why?
Captain's orders, ma'am.
Well, alright, here they are.
Alright, everything here seems to be in order, ma'am. I'm sorry for the disturbance.
That's alright.
Hey, are those fences over there a part of that survival camp of yours?
Yeah?
Well, I hate to break it to you, pal, but we're not the only ones that decided to come over here.
Oh, no.
Okay, so, question? Who are these guys, and, why are they here?
Oh, a long time ago, I made some really poor decisions with some really bad people. You guys should probably stay here as I go find out what they want.
Hey, Jonesy, what's up?
Well, well, well. If it isn't Alec Talek, the man with the plan.
You're in big trouble with the boss this time.
John, don't interrupt me.
Sorry, sir. It won't happen again.
Well, where's our money? A long time ago, we made a deal that you were gonna give us the money to get some tickets for that there fancy aircraft. Where are the tickets?
Well, it's not an aircraft. It's more like a space shuttle, but I don't have the tickets or the money, and the ship flew out like a good 20, 30 minutes ago.
Oh, so you're trying to back out of the deal.
What? Back out of the deal? But I'm not backing out of the deal. The ship legitimately left without me and the damn captain.
Yeah, I'm right here.
So I'm sorry that I didn't get you those tickets. I truly am, but there was literally no way for me to get them if the ship already left like a good 30 minutes ago. I know you told me to meet up here. I completely forgot. My bad, but I don't have the tickets.
You know what? Well, I've just had enough of these lies, so you're just gonna die.
What? No, I think I'm just gonna leave.
But how are you supposed to leave?
Wait, what do you mean?
Now, as I said, you're gonna die.
Quickly, Damien, Malfred, get to that truck over there. Come on, Malfred, it's an easy jump.
No!
Come on, Malfred, you're almost there.
You're dead.
Nobody messes with my cow. Come on, Malfred. We'll find a different way to pull you up.
They're getting away.
All right, let's get out of here.
It's showtime, little Timmy.
Thank you.
shut.
Yeah, I know when to admit defeat, boys. We're probably not gonna win this one.
Yep, they got away. Don't worry, boys. This is but a simple misstep. We'll catch them again, and when we do, we will kill them. We will.
This literally has to be the most exciting, impactful, and terrifying day of my entire life. And I owe it all to you, my good friend.
He's pinning this on me.
Why are you pinning this on me, first off? You're the one that was doing the whole space shuttle octopus thing. And I didn't want to do that. Oh, so you wanted to stay on a dying planet? I mean, that's your thing, I guess. No. I mean, because I didn't like you to begin with. Oh, so you like me now all of a sudden. You make that sound weird. One more time, and I will... Okay, calm down. Look, all I wanted to do today was just, you know, be the captain, Spatial Octopus. Have a bunch of people be like, ooh, he's the captain. It was just me, Damien Ramy, with Damien Days presents Space Shuttle Octopus. Does it have to have the Damien Days present? Yes, it makes it sound cooler. What, would you prefer Space Shuttle Octopus brought to you by Damien Days? Well, that was a strange pause at Damien Days. This must be dried up ocean floor. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it is. What does that have to do with our argument? No, it has to do with that. This was a Damien Day's high-class shuttle. I remember making this. Wait, you were working on space shuttles before Octopus, or... Oh, I'm sorry, that must be confusing. Shuttle, as in, like, an ocean liner. I wouldn't call that a shuttle. No, it was set to sail, that's what I mean.
Alfred, can you do me a favor and stay here for a little bit?
Thanks.
There she is, or there she was. The Damien Days Venator 266, the Wonder Dream.
The Wonder Dream, eh? What a dream.
Oh, you bet she was a dream. Best of her kind, too. I think best I'd manufactured at that time. You won't believe the things you could fit in a boat as tiny as this, too. Though I didn't call it a boat myself, I called it a cruise liner. A luxury one at that.
So... how did it end up here?
My staff had told me that it just sank one day. They didn't tell me the circumstances, but it just sank, and I guess it landed here on this ocean floor, and, you know, ever since it dried up, it's just stayed here. That's the control deck, right? Right here? Yeah, that's where the captain would sit, and, you know, do his thing. What else would it be for? If it sank, where's the crew? Oh, as far as I'm told, the crew was evacuated safely. There were no casualties or injuries of any kind. Not on my watch.
Oh, well, that's a relief. Yeah, if I didn't know that, I probably wouldn't be able to sleep at night.
So, you know this place, and you made it, so... is this where you want to stay the night? Because it's almost dark. You know what? No. I don't...
comfortable here, actually. It's like my work, my life's work, just abandoned with the rest of humanity's mistakes. Right. I've made a lot of mistakes in my past like this, I have to admit. Now come on, grab your cow and let's get out of here. I don't want to be here. At least there were no casualties. Hey, Alec, are you coming or like... No, yeah, give me a minute. I shouldn't tell him. I won't tell him. Yeah. Well, watch your step there, pal. You almost fell. Oh, yeah, just give me a little bit of catch up. Can't leave without one. Yeah, don't worry, we will.
I have to admit, being the captain and sitting at the control modular is pretty sweet.
Sure is, sir.
But remember, we're not here for the power. Humans are despicable. Can you believe the sky used to be blue?
Sir, a woman has seen traveling through the halls, perhaps suspicious of our plot. What shall we do?
Capture her and bring her to me in the multi-purpose room.
Right away, sir.
Hey there, ma'am.
Oh, hello there.
May I ask what you're doing in the hall?
I was just getting to my room. You know, I hear it's not safe to be walking around while the ship is already in motion.
What?
Well, that's why I said I heard it from someone, because I didn't actually believe in it. Wait, what are you doing?
Yeah, nice try, ma'am. Let's get her to the boss.
Let me go! I said let me go!
I'm afraid you cannot be let go, as you already suspect too much.
What? I didn't suspect anything! Just let me go back to my room and I'll forget everything! Please! Who are you?
Who am I? Well, I know you're Jane Ritchie, correct? Here to research any faults in Space Shuttle Octopus, if found?
Yes, that's me.
Well, I assure you, there is nothing wrong here. And to answer your question, my name is Yurik.
Yurik? I never saw you listed on a passenger database. Is that your real name?
It is my name, and you should fear it. It is clear to me and my minions that you already know too much about our master plan.
What? I seriously don't know anything about that. Please!
Quiet with your yapping. It is clear that it is as terrible as your lying. Take her away to the prison.
Prison? What prison? Hey, let me go, damn it!
Very convenient of you to have one of those Damien Days campfires going around, right? Oh yeah, no, we sold them for like $9.99. They were like a huge bomb. Wait, so that thing's gonna explode? No, not that kind of bomb. Oh, okay. Malfred says he's going to step back still. Understandable. So how's your day been going? Oh, it's been going terrible. I got left behind by my own ship, and now I'm stranded here with a cow and an idiot. Why am I the idiot? What have I done? I don't know, you didn't pay those gang members. I mean, they seemed pretty angry at you, specifically. Yeah, well, they were chasing all of us down. Yeah, because of you. Fair point. Look, maybe we can just make amends for tomorrow. How does that sound? And work together? Before we go to bed. Alright, well, I make amends. There, is that what you wanted? Okay, not exactly, but, like, I guess that works. Alright, well, I guess I'll see you in the morning, and, let's try not to bump into anything zany, wacky, or completely disgusting in the morning. Sounds fair. Alright, well, night. Night. Mrrr. Do you have to be laying that close to me? Oh, for crying out loud.
Alfred, is that you?
What the heck are you? Get away from me!
Whoa, what is that thing?
Alfred? Alfred, do you know this strange, strange, horrifying creature? Get my cow out of your mouth! Malfred, are you okay? It's rude to put another man's cow in your mouth.
Whoa, it's amazing.
It's amazing? It just tried to eat my cow.
What? No. Whoa, Alec, it's amazing. It appears your cow has fallen in love with one of those disgusting mutated creatures from those experiments. What? I can't believe this. I won't believe this. Malfred, say this isn't true. But Alec, if it's true love, oh, you be quiet, Damien. Malfred, are you really in love with this thing? Yeah, you've kissed it like 5 times already. Come on, Alec. You don't really want to separate them, do you?
Meh.
been through enough already. I'm letting this slide. You know what? That's it. I'm the cool guy Alec now. I'm awesome. I'm all chill. You know? I'm letting this slide. You know what? Legitimately, This is the problem. I'm letting this slide. This is awesome. I wish we could do this more, you know? Come on, Damien. Let's travel on an adventure.
Yeah, I think he's seen better days. Come on, you lovebirds.
So what now, Chief?
I'll just be honest. I don't really know what to do. I'll tell you what. With an entire crew like this, we can probably go find that ship and take it back.
Really? Take back the ship? That's your idea? Well, yeah, why wouldn't it work? I mean, I am the captain after all.
Guess you are right.
Why would they even steal it from you to begin with? Yeah, we should get the ship back. Yeah, I'm telling you, it's a brilliant idea. Nothing will go wrong.
Yeah, it's like going on a quest.
Yeah, we're going on a quest to take this ship back. Come on, get in the car. I'm passenger seat.
The prisoner has been secured in her cell. Anything else that you would like me to report, sir?
No. I think you're dismissed.
Yes, sir.
Yurik! I thought I might find you in here.
Well, well, well. If it isn't Space Shuttle Octopus co-pilot, Jason, what's its face? It's not like you're important anyways.
Yurik, I have learned of your deception on Space Shuttle Octopus. I have learned how you have deceived everybody into following your orders as captain. The captain's chair that you stole from Damien Ramy. Captain Damien Ramy.
Oh, listen to you blabber on about Damien Ramy.
You may have fooled the entire staff, Yurik, but there is no fooling me. Oh, come on! Even you'd be a better captain than that fool. This you must realize. I may have been just the co-pilot, but I at least respected Ramy as the captain.
Look at you. You don't even have a second in command. I don't need a second in command, because that is how good I am.
Really? Is that how narcissistic you are? You're so good, better than anyone else.
Well, if it's the truth,
you know that what you're doing is wrong.
Don't you have somewhere else to be? Jason!
In fact, I believe I do. Sorry for bothering you.
That is what I thought. I am the captain of this ship. And soon everybody will know what I have in store.
God! I need you to go find and kill Co-Captain Jason.
Now, sir, you know very well we cannot do that.
Why?
You're right. Sorry for bothering you, God. Back to your post.
Feels like we've been driving around forever. Are we almost there? Yeah, I think. I don't remember where it was. Oh, come on. We were just there a few days ago. Ah, wait. I think I see it ahead. Wait, is it actually? Yeah.
Alright, so where's this helicopter of yours? Oh, hold up. I think I can just call it. Helicopter, activate. It's not just gonna come to you like that. Well, you'll be surprised at the technology of today, my friend. It'll just come to me.
Boom! Technology. Alright, so what's the plan?
It's really simple. All we're going to do is use the helicopter to get onto the ship, and then I'll make it up from there. So there's no real solid plan. I'm building it. Alright.
What the heck is that thing?
Whoa, what do you think that thing could be? Well, I'm not sure what it is, but I sure do know who's involved with it.
Well, hey there, everybody. Bet you weren't expecting to see me again.
Gasp! That guy! That guy? What do you want?
I believe that you and your new colorful cast of characters once owed me something. Then I realized I don't need anything from you. I got everything I got with my crew. So, I picked this up back from when the war was still around. Could destroy a country in a matter of seconds. That's how powerful it is. Now I'm gonna use it against you, and you're gonna die. Sorry, not sorry.
Ugh, we don't have time for this. We have to get to that helicopter now. So sorry, but we're not in the mood to fight right now. Go away. Come on, man. This is like one final obstacle we have to get to. You know, like kind of like a big final battle to our adventure, right? What? No. Yeah, and you say something like, "Oh, we'll stop you." Because that sounds cool.
I'm afraid that stopping me is not an option. Oh, boys!
Okay, yeah, so that might be a problem.
Before you get to me, you gotta get through them!
Well, it looks like this is happening. Come on, let's go help her!
Weapons charging up. My bad. Boys, fall in.
Oh no, that thing's gonna kill us. No, it's not. The creature, come with me.
No, not you, boys. No, you stay there where I can target you. No, don't. Son of a chicken nugget!
Owen, hit it up there and hope it starts a chain reaction. Alright, now run! What did you do? It's gonna blow!
What's happening?
Sir, somehow we've been blasted with fire in the undersection. There's going to be a hyperblast due to its gas radiation.
What does that mean?
It's gonna blow!
The creature. You saved us.
Wait, how did it save us? Oh, it acted as a shield against smoke and debris. Just figured that out. Well, still didn't save you from that piece of debris that hit your head. Come on, let's go to your helicopter. Wait, is the helicopter even still there? That explosion was pretty big. So are we not gonna talk about how we just blew up a giant vehicle? I mean, that was awesome! Yeah, but what's past is past. Right now, we have to focus on getting back onto Space Shuttle Octopus. Wow, that sounded so mature. Alright, let's go check on the helicopter. By Jove, the helicopter survives. What's that? Oh, don't worry, Malford. I'm sure we'll all fit. Well, why is that a concern? Malford, it fits all of us. As in Damien, me, and you. We're not actually taking that thing. Malford, watch your language. Wait, what's he saying? He wants us to take the creature up to the ship. Malfred, I'm so sorry, but I don't think the creature's gonna fit on the helicopter. I'm sorry, Malfred. Malfred, we'll be waiting for you on the helicopter. Suppose this is where the creature and you part ways. Come on. I'm sorry, Malfred. I guess it just wasn't meant to be. Dude, spare the cow some pain. Just get on the helicopter. Okay. Alright, gang. Let's go.
Sir, our forces have detected what appears to be Damien Ramy's helicopter heading towards the ship.
Damien Ramy's helicopter?
Yes.
Coming to this ship.
Yes.
Is he in there?
I don't know, probably.
Well, if he's in there, welcome him in with open arms. I want to see Damien Ramy.
Yes, sir.
So what's your plan? Oh, trust me, I know this ship inside out, mostly because I made it. There's a docking bay on that roof portion over there. We can just land there and act like we're passengers late to the trip. Then we might be able to pull this off. Really? Yeah, watch.
Hello, this is Space Shuttle Octopus Control. Whose helicopter is this?
We're just a bunch of humble passengers that accidentally missed the flight time. We're just here with our helicopter hoping if we can park inside and then redeem our tickets.
I see, and do you have tickets?
Yes, we have the tickets.
Alright, park your helicopter through the opening and we'll validate your tickets.
Well, shoot. Thank you very much.
See? Easy peasy.
What was that?
I was just trying to log off. Thank you very much.
See? Easy peasy. Okay, you may now exit out of your vehicle. Oh my god, Malfred just killed some dude. He's probably fine. Someone can survive a drop like that.
Sir, the helicopter has landed.
Good. Now, just to be sure, let's go send a troop transport to scan the area where the helicopter took off.
Right away, sir.
Come on, move it! Move it!
Thank you.
All right, men. We know our mission.
What was that? What was what? I swear I just saw something run by. Oh my god! Sir, what's happening? I think we're being hunted. Dear God. What is that thing? It doesn't matter! Shoot! Shoot! Hey guys, is everything okay in there? Hey there, little friend. You looking for a ride onto Space Shuttle Octopus? Come on, I can get you aboard.
Alright, so where exactly are we going? Oh, we're going to my captain's chambers, but it might be a dangerous way. Who knows how many armed guards there might be, or how many traps. Wait, there's traps? Oh, there isn't actually any traps in my captain's chamber. I'm just assuming there's going to be traps. You know, big evil takeover, they usually do that kind of thing. Oh, yeah, I get it now. Best be careful and sneaky, like a ninja. Got it? Alright, let's go.
So I told him that wasn't my milk, because that expired 2 days ago. Wow, really?
Hey, yeah. Have you ever seen the first Star Wars movie?
No. And now my dad wants me to. And those aren't my noodles. I'd recognize my noodles. Of course you would. They're yours. Yeah, and so I...
Wow, Malfred's on a roll today.
Are you ready? Yeah, let's go.
Aw, man, I hope we get to your captain's chamber soon. I can't see a thing in this helmet. Okay, we're gonna have to pause here. Wait, why?
There's three of my elite soldiers waiting in the hallway.
So, that means?
They detect everything. Act as casually as you can. Got it.
Yo, what's up, guys? It's just us, normal soldiers. Don't mind us. Hey, working hard or hardly working, you know how it is, right?
Good job, Alec. That was real casual.
Sir, we found them. They're heading towards the captain's chamber.
Almost there? Yeah, just follow me. The door's right there. Oh, I can practically see myself piloting the ship already. Freeze! Oh no. Malfred, come on, this is the part where you beat them up. Like you did before. Malfred? He didn't follow us? No, I don't think. So, you two are just standing there, huh?
What the... Where are we? Oh, finally, you woke up. Yeah, I woke up a few minutes earlier than you. We're just kind of like tied up in a bunch of chains in this strange contraption. What? I can't even move my neck. Well, I would have more mobility, but, you know, my arm is tied back, so...
Shh. Quiet. The captain is about to speak.
Why are you whispering?
Shh.
That doesn't answer my I said shush! Okay.
Well, well, well. If it isn't Damien Ramy. Good job, minions, for capturing him.
Oh, jeez, it was no hard work, Master. Okay, look, this is all fine and dandy, but do you mind explaining who the hell you are?
I
am Yurikul, and I am your worst nightmare.
Ooh, yeah, no, Yurikul? Yurikul. That's a weird name. Does it purposefully sound like urinal, Yurikul? Hey, Yurikul, look at me when I'm talking to you. Stop facing your back to me.
You're right. You might actually know me by a different name.
Jason? Wait, hold on a minute. Who's Jason? Jason, he was supposed to be my co-pilot on the journey. I even had a conversation right before I bumped into you. Jason, why would you do this?
Quiet, Rami. We both knew you were too stupid to power this ship.
Whoa, I mean, Jason. Is your real name even Jason? Is it actually Urinal? I mean, Yurik?
Silence! Now I now have something that you will never have, Rami. I have the entire human race at my grasp.
Oh, well, yeah, great, Jason. This is exactly what we need. Yet another angry man that wants power.
Oh, you think I want the power? Oh, you think that's what I'm getting out of this? Well, no offense, Mr. Rami, but I could care less about the power that I now possess.
Well, come on, Jason, what could you possibly want then? We're buddies.
Ever since you designed the ship? I mean, no offense, Mr. Rami, but everything down to the conception of this ship was all going according to my design. I perfectly orchestrated a plot where you would get left behind so I can take control of the ship and guide it off course as me and my followers escaped back to the surface where we can start a new humanity, and we would sit and watch as the humans that let the Earth suffer fell in a fiery explosion of death!
Oh my god, you're going to let the ship crash down.
I am, if it wasn't already obvious. Now, if you excuse me, Mr. Rami, I have more planning to do.
No, please! No! You can't get away with this! You won't get away with this!
Come on, this way, you dirty prisoners. What are you? You're just a cow. Come on, let's get you guys to yourselves. Hey, Miss Richie, I have some new inmates here for you.
What are you in for? What? Your friends are in need of rescue? Well, come on, I think I can help them.
My plan will work. Everything is going as planned.
It will fail, you know. Your plan. It's quite flawed, actually.
Please, enlighten me.
Damien Rami will break out. He will escape, and then when he does, he shall foil your plans. With the help of his new friends, which you helped him make by deserting him on Earth to begin with.
What do you know? You're just me from the past, a distant memory. Someone dead.
You mean nothing to me now, and therefore your advice is meaningless. Well, not advice, really, more like insight.
Useless. Garbage insight. All of you with this talk of foiling my plans.
He'll break out. He'll stop me.
He'll stop me, will he? Because what? I'm painted as the bad guy? Am I the bad guy here? Because you all are the bad guys here. I'm the one with a vision. A vision with a clear path that, frankly, you do not understand. And you are insane to believe otherwise.
Insane? Insane, you say? Well, Yurik, I hate to break it to you, but you're not the one talking to yourself.
I don't want to talk to myself. I don't want to talk to you. I don't want to deal with your ignorance. I don't want you here. I want you out of my head!
I see. Well, you should have told me sooner. Goodbye, Yurik. Have fun failing.
My plan will work. I'm telling you, my plan will work.
Is this how you ever expected you were gonna go out? Trapped in your own ship in the prison cells? Well, never really expected for my second in command to even take over the ship to begin with, so you know. I guess, yeah, this is a surprise. There weren't any clues beforehand that he might have been planning something? Oh, no, no, not at all. I mean, I thought he was completely clean. Hey, I know this isn't saying much, but thank you. Thank you? Why thank you? I mean, for the longest time, I've just been so focused on my image and the company. Damien Days, travel. Still haven't even come up with a good catchphrase for it, by the way. I guess I was too focused on the material things, you know? The cars, the houses, the pools, the ladies. Yeah, I think I get the point. I thought Jason was like a friend, but he was always just a business guy. And now, look at us. He turned out to be evil. Captured us. I guess what I'm trying to say is, before we went on this whole journey of being left behind on the ship and the quest, as you'd like to call it, I never really had a real friend. Well, I mean, the only friend I ever had was Malfred, really, so yeah, you know, it's a win-win scenario. We all got friends. Yeah. Malfred. Well, I already had Malfred. And the weird creature thing we just met. Yeah, that's our friend, too. So, any ideas on what to do till we eventually die and rot here? I don't know, I mean, I would have brought like a game of cards or something, but, you know, they took all our things. Yeah. Hey, why'd they leave me in handcuffs? I don't know, because you're the most dangerous person of them, I guess? But why? I'm weak. Okay, well, that's like being really honest. I know! Well, what do you want to talk about? Well, I once met this... What? You hear that? Yeah, I hear it too. Do you see anybody?
Malfred!
The creature! Oh, we might want to stand back. Huh? Why? Oh, I see.
Oh my god, I can't believe you guys actually came to rescue us.
What? It was the combined power of love.
Really? But how did you guys escape?
Are you guys okay?
Oh, was it with the help of Miss Richie here, I presume?
No. Just no. It was the cow's idea.
Oh, okay. Well, thanks. We wouldn't have made it out. Without the creature, I guess. What was that? Superpowered sneeze or something?
Superpowered sneezes don't matter right now. Anyone have a report on Yurik?
Yurik has taken control of everything on the ship. We leave him for another few minutes, the human race goes kaboom!
Oh, that is bad. Okay, alright, so I have an idea. The creature and Malfred, you guys go split up with Miss Richie, and me and Alec will go face down Jason.
Wait, hold on, how did you escape? Or were you not even held as a prisoner to begin with?
Oh, I was helped out by your cow and whatever that thing is.
Well, come on, we have no time to lose, let's get going!
Alright, come on!
Wait, quick question. Hold on, I'm still trying to get the handcuffs off. Yeah. Okay, well, the creature was able to bite at them, but I think this is pretty much all we got for now.
Okay, well, back to the important question. What exactly is the plan?
Okay, so I'm just gonna be honest, it was kind of like the rush of adrenaline, you know, like the big escape scene. Yeah, I don't really know. Just face down Jason, like I said. Yeah, but what exactly does that mean? Let's just go kick his butt? That's pretty much what it means, right?
Hey! Oh my god, the prisoners have escaped! Jeebus, heckin' Christo, you did not have to go so hard on the guy!
Yeah, sorry, again, as you said, the adrenaline. Now, come on, let's go!
Okay.
Sir.
What is this?
It's time for your public appearance with our men.
Yes. Yes.
My men, you are here today because you support a great cause. The cause for the planet. The extinction of humanity will save us all.
And it will be up to us, as the last remaining humans, to build everything up in a grander way. The Yurik way.
The Yurik way! All hail Yurik, savior of man! All hail Yurik, savior of man!
Music, sweet music to my ears.
Ooh, I've got a plan! What is it? So he doesn't know we've broken out yet, right? So, we let him execute his plan. You know, he goes down to Earth's surface, right as he's about to pop out the popcorn and chair. We take control of his ship, fly out of there. He'll be like, wait, what happened? My plan, it was going so perfect. What went wrong? Right? It's genius. It's genius. Okay, so that was actually not too bad of an idea, but it was very poorly explained. Yeah, there's literally no way it can go wrong. Unless someone tells him that we broke out, which I doubt. I have an idea. This way.
All right.
It looks to me like it's time to celebrate the success of this plan and bring out some popcorn. Yurik, I found you. What happened to you? I got super punched in the face. Oh, it hurt so bad.
Wait, what?
Oh, it's Damien Rami. He's escaped. They've all escaped.
Ah! Do you not know your job, you imbecile?
Wait, hold up, where are we going? You'll see!
This is fine. We can still execute the plan like this. Just some minor adjustments may be needed.
Sir?
What is it? I'm trying to come up with the adjustments!
Sir, seriously, you better look!
Huh?
Oh, Jesus! Ah!
You! Aha! Coming at you all, Wicked Witch of the East style! But we didn't drop a house on him. No, yeah, but we, like, dropped the small ship on him. Well, he avoided it. Aww.
I don't understand. Why are you trying to foil my plan to save humanity?
Your plan to save humanity includes destroying all of humanity, and therefore must be destroyed. Wait, we're not destroying anything. No, I meant as in, like, destroy his plan. Ah, I see. Well, time to drive off.
Wait, what? Get up, men!
Alright, so you got the plan, right? Yeah. Distract everybody here, blast off, and then secretly go to the captor's chambers and claim it back. Alright, let's go!
What the?
Remember locking me up?
Am I supposed to? Stay down!
Ah!
chamber! Ah! Yeah, this plan worked perfectly! A bit confusing, yet effective. We'll be back at the captain's chamber in no time? Wait, what the?
You really think you can foil my plans that easily? You're dead wrong!
What are you wearing? Wait, Yurik, that's experimental. You're not careful, it can blow you up. Wait, did I just call him Yurik? Jason, I meant Jason.
Jason is dead! I am Yurik, savior of man!
Whoa! Yurik, you don't have to do this. There's other ways to save humanity. Like the entire concept of this ship.
I don't care.
Jason, you don't have to fight us.
Oh, I don't, but I would very much like to.
Genius!
This is a little too close to the edge, right? We might fall!
If you fall, the better!
Yurik, stop! Don't!
I'm sorry, Damien Rami. You have to go. Any last words? Well, yes, actually.
Come on. Get up. Whoa, you did it. You defeated Yurik. Well, it was really more like a team effort, wasn't it? You're the hero of Space Shuttle Octopus. You saved us all. Well, I wouldn't go that far. You're a hero. Take the compliment. All right. Hi, Alfred.
Are you guys okay?
Oh no, yeah. We're all fine here. Mr. Alec over here saved the day. He keeps calling me a hero. I didn't do much.
Well, whatever you did, Yorick's gone. Your plan was a complete success.
Yeah, my plans are the best. And, there goes your ship. Oh, never mind, it's too late. Hey, what are the chances of that ship, falling directly onto him? Well, I'd say, for the sake of him not coming back, 100%. Yeah, but the fall probably did it, didn't it? Yeah, it did, didn't it? Well, what now? You should probably go public about the takeover. Really? It's not really necessary. The passengers need to know. Plus, they probably heard a bunch of explosions and fighting and a bunch of ships going around. Ooh, yeah, that is concern-worthy. How do we tell the public? I have an idea.
All right. We're broadcasting live in 3, 2, 1. Passengers of Space Shuttle Octopus, this is your captain, Damien Ramy.
The ship was just a part of an attempted takeover plan, but let me assure you right now
that we have everything under control, and the evildoers have been stopped and apprehended.
So, if you felt any shaking or heard any explosions, that's our bad. You know, we had to take them down all cool-like. Anyways,
And now I will direct you to enter your rooms and fasten your bed seat belts, because we're about to leave the atmosphere.
Alright, how was that?
That was great! I don't know why you're asking, considering it was live, so we can't do it again.
Right.
We can finally close out this entire adventure, huh? Yeah, I suppose it's over. It was pretty fun, though, wasn't it?
I suppose it was. Yeah.
Oh, and, Miss Ritchie.
I am so sorry for getting you involved in all of this.
Oh, it's quite all right. I actually got myself involved.
Oh? So, what will you do now?
Oh, I'll probably just go to my room. Try to process what just happened.
Right. Well, have fun with that.
So, what do you think is going to happen to Earth? I'm not too sure. It seriously needs some alone time. No more humans, no more pollution, nothing. Just leave it alone for a couple thousand years. Maybe it'll get better, you know? Yeah. Well, we should probably get back to our rooms. Yeah. Good luck being captain. Good luck being a normal citizen on this ship. Yeah. Yeah. Well, I'm the captain. Come on, you two. This is my room. No, yeah, take your time. I'm not too sure that thing's gonna fit through the door, Malfred, but okay. You two figure that out. That works, I guess. Come in. Hey there, Alec. What's up?
Oh, Damien. What a pleasant surprise.
Oh, what can I do for you? I thought our big adventure thing was over.
Well, yeah, it is, but, you know, it's kind of lonely in the cabin, and you deserve more than just a regular room. I mean, you saved the ship. You're the hero. Well, I wouldn't really go that far, but... And I really need a co-captain, so, are you offering me to become the new co-captain? Yeah, something like that. I mean, only if you want to, you know?
Let me think about it.
Yeah, got it.
The purple button does nothing. Right to go left, left to go right, down to go up, and up to go down. The Diet Coke button is just there because of the president, and the steering wheels do what normal steering wheels do.
Yeah, none of these buttons are confusing. I understood all of that.
Did you actually?
I'm not too sure I'm gonna be too good at this co-pilot thing.
Don't worry, I'm sure you'll get used to all the buttons in no time. Alright, get ready. We're about to blast off!
We're not doing much blasting.
Did you hit the hyper button?
The hyper button?
Alright, now let's blast off.
Come fly with me, let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay. Come fly with me, let's fly away. Come fly with me, let's float down to Peru. In Llama Land, there's a one-man band, and he'll toot his flute for you. Come fly with me, let's take off in the blue. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just fly starry-eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so near. You may hear angels cheer, 'cause we're together. Weather-wise, it's such a lovely day. Just say the words and we'll beat the birds down to Acapulco Bay. Perfect for a flying honeymoon, they say. Come fly with me, let's fly away. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just glide starry-eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you.
They did it. They successfully left. My plan foiled. Well, best use my mechanical engineering degree for good use.